today. We're taking out the Suzuki GSX-S, taking out a naked version. So what we thought to do today was to bring it out around some regular roads and see how it copes really for everyday riding. So yeah, first impressions is I thought this was going to bite me today. I thought I was going to pull out of the showroom and then it was going to lift its wheel in the air, shake its head and snort at me like a wild pig. But I'm pleasantly surprised, despite all the reviews by the big magazines, that this is somewhat of a pussycat round town, which is what I was hoping it would be. I've got no doubt whatsoever to its claims on the track or on the twisties, but that's not what this review's about really. It's, can you live with this bike? Yeah, probably could. In the real world, you know, this is what I do. Sunday jaunt out, Wednesday night up to the Scotch Piper, the odd long jaunt, and this would be perfect. Obviously I'm on a naked model. The third model that they do has got the exact same ergonomics, so the seating position is the same, the peg position is the same and so on, but you've got that protection from the elements, and you've also got more of an aggressive look really, rather than a street bike look, which might suit some riders. But yeah, this thing does want to turn. The minute it gets the sense that there's a corner coming up, it wants to go in. So yeah, it's fun. I've got this set on. This has got a three stage, well actually four stage if you count the off as well position, but you can see traction control. I don't know if you can see that. I've got that set on too at the moment, which is for Suzuki claim that's for everyday round town riding. You can switch the whole thing off, you can have it on one, which will still allow you to spin the back wheel up as you exit corners, but it won't get you into any trouble. This bike's fitted with the Yoshi cam. Which sounds really, really well. In fairness, the standard cam also sounds good. But this is just that little bit better. Also the Yoshi Special Edition, it comes with things like Yoshi bar ends, Yoshi centre nuts, just a few little nice touches really to stand it out as a special edition. The bike's available in many different colours. You've got this blue, which I believe is Triton blue, which you can see is MotoGP-esque, as you know, Suzuki, they're now in their second season on their return to MotoGP and doing really well. And so for all you MotoGP fans out there, you can be Vinales riding this bike. It's also available in a fantastic matte grey and also black and red. I suppose the question that I always ask whenever I'm riding or test riding a bike is, would I be happy to go and buy this? Is it the sort of thing that I'd open the garage door on a Sunday and it would make me smile? And would I be comfortable riding it as an everyday tool? I've only been on this bike for 5 minutes, but straight away that's a resounding yes. It's far more comfortable than I thought it would be. It feels like a sports bike. You can tell it's got pedigree. Yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. The good thing about it too, certainly in this colour scheme, is it gets looks. When I was strapping cameras to it and whatnot earlier on at the dealership, there's so many people that had come out the dealership, and because the sunshine was on it, they said, oh man, that looks fantastic. And it does, it really does. The roll power mid-range is phenomenal. It is unbelievable. It's smooth, it's relentless. Yeah, Suzuki certainly have delivered with this package. They couldn't have put a better power plant in this kind of machine. It's just phenomenal. It's a pussycat round sound. Contrary to what I believed when I threw my leg over it this morning, it's not going to kill me. It's incredible. It really is incredible. This bike, although derived from the GSX-R, is designed more for people like myself, whose wrists and back just won't stand up to sports bikes any longer. But we still like to get out and get the feel that we're on a pedigree machine. The engine in this bike is the K5, which, for those geeks amongst you, you'll know that that's the engine that powered the GSX-R from 2005 to 2008. It's also the engine that powered Troy Corsa to win his world championship. And what Suzuki have done is they've taken this bike, they've put lighter pistons in, they've changed the head, they've changed the inlet and outlet valves, and they've tuned the machine to be more useful as an everyday bike really, rather than as a track tilt. They've lowered the pegs, they've brought them further forward, and although I'm still in a sporty position, what it's actually done is it's took the weight off my wrists. I've been on this bike now probably half an hour. I've not got any aches in my back. There's no aches in my wrists whatsoever. I've not got pins and needles in my fingers through lack of blood supply. And yeah, I still feel as though I'm riding a bike with phenomenal pedigree. And rightly so. This bike comes in lighter than the GSX-R. And Suzuki claimed that around town and obviously on the public roads, this bike's faster than the GSX-R. Take it on the track and the GSX-R will have the edge, but Suzuki have made it that it's probably only just. I think you'd run out of talent before this bike ran out of performance. This bike feels every little undulation in the road surface, not in a way that knocks the rider's confidence, but in a way that delivers really, really good feedback as to what's going on underneath the bike. Roads like this that you're thankful you've got traction control, because a little bit damp, there's some loose gravel in parts, and this thing just goes over it like it's a freshly laid road. Suzuki aim this bike at? Suzuki claims to aim this bike at what they think would be a typical customer, someone who's over the age of 40. They've been sport bike riders in the past, and they still want the performance and feel of a sports bike, but with a riding position that's a little more forgiving. Having done probably 50-60 miles on this bike now, I'd say that I think Suzuki should target a wider audience. This bike's not just for people that's had sports bikes in the past, but for anybody really that's had maybe, you know, a naked bike, who want to upgrade to something a little better. Please believe me when I tell you that this bike is so well behaved. It really is. Yeah, this bike, it just inspires confidence. There's been times, and I'm sure you'll agree with me, those of you that ride sports bikes, that they're just not designed for the everyday sort of road. You've seen the condition of some of the roads that I've been on today. We've got puddles, it's damp, there's some grit, there's potholes, there's grooves in the road, there's overbanding, and this thing just goes over them as if, you know, as if we're going down Silverstone. It's got absolutely no concerns. Certainly is much more stable than what you'd give it credit for looking at it on paper. So how are we going to sum this up? Pound for pound, in terms of pound note value, this comes out top. It's considerably cheaper than its rivals. It delivers almost 145 brake horsepower. Has a ridiculous amount of mid-range, low-range, it's just an unbelievable thing. And yet, as I've said before, it's as well-behaved as your grandmother's Mini Metro. Would I buy the bike? Yes, I would. There's no two ways about it. If I was in the market for a new bike, which I probably will be later on in the year, this is definitely going in my top three. It's a good looker. It rides well. It's stable. And it's got enough power to make my heart beat a little faster each time I throw my leg over it. If nothing else, I'd suggest go down to the Suzuki dealer, book a test ride, and judge for yourself. Let's just roll that mid-range power on again. That is just... it's just beyond belief, really. We're doing this road test, obviously, on the public road, so given it's on video, we've got to stay legal. But believe me when I say this, when you want to, you could take this on a track and it would totally transform the machine. Are there any bad points? Not as I can see, if I'm honest. I was expecting some snatchy acceleration, but it simply hasn't got it. I don't know whether that was a pre-release review that I'd read on the internet that said it was snatchy going back on the gas, but really I've not felt it at all today, not once. Why should you buy this bike? Well, one, it's cheaper than its main competitors. Two, it's incredibly addictive. It handles phenomenally well. It can wear several different hats. It's a commuter, it's a leisure vehicle, it's a proper track tool. It's an incredible package that Suzuki have put together. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
So I'm rolling back into the dealership now, Millenium Motors in St. Helens, and I'll be honest, I could stay out on this all day, I really could. So there we have it, the Suzuki GSX-S. I'm on the naked model, it's also available third. What a stunning bit of kit.